Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to use hyperbolic identities to simplify a hyperbolic function. To complete this problem, we'll make substitutions for the values of the hyperbolic functions and then simplify as much as possible. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to use hyperbolic identities to prove that hyperbolic cosine squared of x minus hyperbolic sine squared of x is equal to 1. And because those are the two hyperbolic functions that we've been given here in our problem, I've written out the formula or the identity for each one. So what we're going to do is just plug in the value here or the identity for each one of these in our problem and then simplify as much as we can. So we'll go ahead and plug in e to the x plus e to the negative x divided by 2 for cosine or hyperbolic cosine. But keep in mind that we've got this squared here, so we have to indicate that that identity is squared. And then plugging in for hyperbolic sine, we'll get e to the x minus e to the negative x all divided by 2. And same thing here. We've got hyperbolic sine squared, so we have to square it, and then we set that equal to 1. And if you need help remembering these identities, I have a table of these identities on the hyperbolic identities page of my website. So now we just need to simplify as much as possible. So what we're going to have over here is e to the x plus e to the negative x squared, so times e to the x plus e to the negative x. And that's all going to be over 2 squared, which is 4. So we've simplified the denominator, but we still need to simplify the numerator. And then over here in the second term, we have same thing, e to the x minus e to the negative x times e to the x minus e to the negative x. It'll just help us to write this out so we can see what we're doing. And then in the denominator, we'll have 4 because we get 2 squared, set equal to 1. So now we're just going to FOIL this. So we're going to multiply e to the x by e to the x, then e to the x by e to the negative x, etc. So keep in mind that when you're multiplying these terms together, these terms with base e, these exponential functions, you're adding the exponents. So remember that e to the x times e to the x, we take the two exponents, x and x, and we add them together to get 2x. So e to the x times e to the x is e to the 2x. Same thing here, when we multiply e to the x by e to the negative x, we add the exponents, and when we add x plus a negative x, we get 0. E to the 0, or anything to the 0 power, is just 1, so we get plus 1. And then same thing here, multiplying e to the negative x times e to the x, add the exponents, and we get e to the 0. E to the 0 is 1, so we get plus 1. And then e to the negative x times e to the negative x will give us e to the negative 2x because we're adding those exponents. Then we can go ahead and we'll just combine both fractions as we go here. So we'll get minus, and then e to the x times e to the x gives us e to the 2x. E to the x times e to the negative x will get that 0 in the exponent, so it's just going to be 1, so we get minus 1. Same thing here, when we multiply these together, we get another minus 1. And then e to the negative x times e to the negative x, we get a plus e to the negative 2x. All divided by 4 will be equal to 1. So now when we simplify our numerator, we'll get e to the 2x plus 2 plus e to the negative 2x. Minus, when we distribute this negative sign, e to the 2x plus 2 minus e to the negative 2x. That whole thing, of course, is still divided by 4, so divided by 4 equal to 1. So now, if we start canceling terms, we can see that we'll get the e to the 2x minus e to the 2x, those will cancel, e to the negative 2x minus e to the negative 2x, those will cancel. And all we're left with, if we go over here, all we're left with is the 2 here and the 2 here, so we end up with 4 over 4, and that's equal, of course, to 1. So we get 1 equals 1. And that's how we can prove that this function up here, this hyperbolic function, is equal to 1 using hyperbolic identities. So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.